What is up, guys? Welcome back to another video. I know it's been maybe a week or a little over a week since I last posted a video, but as you can see the truck here behind me, I don't know if you can see it, but it's basically done. I'm gonna give you guys a little rundown of it didn't go as smoothly as I wanted, but I'll give you guys a rundown here. But there it is. These wheels do stick out quite a bit. It's got all the stance. The only problem we came into was in the last video I mentioned the strut tower stud piece. It's Moog brand. If you guys checked it out, you'd know. And these studs go into this really thin ring, and once I started tightening them, they just started spinning, so they wouldn't tighten at all. So basically put the truck all the way back together, took it over to my buddy's house because he's got a welder over there, and we were able to, of course, take it all back apart again and both sides and get it all fixed up. But it was spinning on both sides, so we had to weld the whole piece together. I'm surprised that it wasn't the greatest quality, being that it was Moog brand. But, you know, I guess every company has its little things. But other than that, as you can see, these wheels do stick out quite a bit. And the truck looks so good with this lift. It might look like it's a little lower in the rear. My driveway is kind of slanted, kind of. That and the front still gonna settle more as time passes. But I think it came out really, really good. Some people, this may bother you guys, the little fender piece right here. I've been meaning to take that off, but I just haven't gotten around to it. I've been busy this last week, that's why I haven't gotten a video up of it or anything. I have been driving it, even though I have not got it aligned yet. But I already got an appointment tomorrow. Yeah, tomorrow, it'd be tomorrow, to get it aligned. So we're gonna get that done. I have driven it pretty far. I think it's about 2.5-3 hours away there and back, so I've been sending it with no alignment, but haven't really seen any odd wear so far. But we should get that taken care of tomorrow. Other than that, the truck looks awesome. It literally came out how I wanted it to, maybe even a lot better. But yeah, like I said, it's a 6-inch lift, super lift. It's a really, really good kit. I have really no complaints. The only things that really held me back were just problems that the truck gave me, just because it's an old truck, and you know, rust and all that crap. But other than that, the kit's really good. The instructions are very good. I had no problems installing this. This was my first time installing a lift. And, yeah, I'm very happy with it. It runs a lot smoother, or rides a lot smoother than it did before with just the pucks. And I have heard that just putting a block on the rear, it's a lot smoother ride, because if you get new leaf springs, it's a lot stiffer because they're new. I have not yet put my bumper on, as you can see, because I did have to cut the bolts from here. Like I said, all that rust and stuff, they're just seized up. But I just haven't gotten around to buying the hardware for it. But it'll go back on here in the next couple days. But I got my little... my plate on here, so I'm legal. Use some speaker wire I found and zip tied my light on here. just in case, just to make it legal for now. As you can see, I don't know if you can see from over here, we did get our exhaust on. It is a 5-inch straight pipe all the way back. It sounds really good. I'll turn on the truck here for you guys here in a second so you can hear it. It is painted black, like a matte black, all the way to the front. As you can see, it's got the black tip, but it sounds really good. But yeah, that's kind of just the truck itself. Like I said, I did drive it, sorry if the sun's in the way, but I did drive it pretty far. As you guys remember, I sealed up the front timing cover again and put in a new crank seal, and it hasn't leaked yet at all, so that's good. It's been running very well so far, but obviously it needs an alignment, so we'll get that done tomorrow. Some people may, you know, debate, why would you do this to this old truck? You know, it's, I know it's a freaking rust bucket in certain areas, but I'm really proud of this thing, how far it's come. If you follow me on Instagram or Snapchat, if you follow me on Instagram, you'll see some of the pictures of when I first got it and the process that it's came this far. And I feel really good about it because I built this thing so far myself. Some people may be like, you know, intake, exhaust, it's not a build, but this is just getting started. But I think I've got the truck looking how I want it. I just have some odds and ends here to get rid of, and then we'll start doing, maybe getting rowdy with it. But I'm happy with how it came out overall. But anyways, other than that, guys, I don't think I have gone over the tires that I put on this thing. They are 35 12 and a half 20s LTs. They are Nido Trail Grappler MTs. Like I told you guys, I got them used, but it looks really good. The wheels look really good on here. Couldn't be happier with how they look. As you can see, these have a lot more tread than the other ones. He said he replaced two of them at one point, but they're good for now, you know. And then I was gonna make a separate video about like all the imperfections in this thing, but might as well do it now. As you can see, we got this dent right here. It was already there when we got the truck. Got a little bit of rust starting there, or just the paint chipping. Of course, my rocker's pretty bad. As you can see, big old hole. Somebody sprayed some foam in there. It was already like that when I got it. The bed, it's a newer bed. I got it painted and everything, but let's stop here real quick. The front bumper, it's got a dent right there, and I don't know if you can see from right here on this side, it's kind of bent in. You can see it more now, and you can see it's got that gap right here, and it doesn't line up at all, so it's tweaked. It's already like that too when I got it. I got a different bumper, but it's got a dent right here, so we might try to punch that dent out and then just switch out the plastics, and then we'll have a nicer looking bumper. As you can see over here, it lines up perfectly. And then over here, you can see we got some rust start down here on this fender. I know this thing isn't perfect by any means, but like I said, you know, some people may wonder, okay, why'd you do all this to this truck, blah blah blah. I like this thing. I really just do like this thing. As you can see right here, like I said, I did get the battery done and everything, but this right here was a mistake by yours truly. But don't really want to get into that right now. But yeah, this was before, this was the good side with no rust here or anything. But then that happened. All it had on this side was is this scratch already. But other than that, the truck's not in too bad a shape. I mean, me personally, I don't think this thing's gonna go anywhere. But who knows? I might just end up fixing all that stuff on it too. But overall, I think this thing looks great. I have no complaints whatsoever. But like I said, Super Lift's a great kit. Not sponsored by them by any means, but I'm really happy with the kit itself, the instructions, everything. It was just, you know, on point. But yeah, we'll get it started here for you guys so you guys can hear it. Get a little montage going. So you guys can see how good this thing looks.
pack to my pulse flat. We keep it real, no false rap. I got four cars and they all black. Got four bras and they all that. We call that ballin'. Doing this is my calling. Flow is so appalling. My phone off and she calling. I'm like, yeah, what it do? Penthouse, man, what a view. Fall back cause I'm coming through with my whole team. They coming too, that's real. Too real, motherfucker, tell me how you feel. I'm too good for my own good. I won't leak the album, I let it spill. Number one, bitch, I bet it will. Do the numbers, I said it will. I played the game and I'm still the same. And I never change just to get a deal, bitch, I'm ballin'. I came from nothing to something like it's nothing. Yeah, you know I done it. That is no discussion, bitch, I'm ballin'. I made a promise to my mama. I'ma turn these zeros into tens of commas. Bitch, I'm ballin'. Closing $1 million deals. Catch me swerving, burning $100 bills. How I feel when you ballin'. Going places they never go. It ain't all about the money, but I stack it cause you never know. I'ma live life till I overdose. Where they sleeping on me, that's comatose. I went mainstream with my main team. You just mad as fuck, you ain't come close. And your next girl is my ex-girl. She fine as hell, but she a mess, girl. All I do is rhyme, I got no time. So I can't reply to your text, girl. But I'm back again and I run it. Always gotta keep it 100.
Guys, I don't know if you can hear me very well. The truck's running behind me, but hope you guys like that little I forgot what it's called. Anyways, I hope you guys like the little clip of the truck. You know, I'm excited to see how it looks, you know, just driving around. I haven't looked at the clips yet. I'm hoping the wheels look pretty cool, you know, spinning as they go down the road. But I think that's gonna do it for today's video. Figured I, you know, finally get the reveal out of the way. Like I said, there's still some another maintenance thing we have to do this thing, but that'll probably be in the next few videos. But if you enjoyed this upload, make sure you give it a big thumbs up. Stay tuned, subscribe if you haven't, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace.